I would like to introduce Noelle George, who is the executive director of the Foundation Beyond Belief, and she and her staff are going to present the Heart of Humanism Awards.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. First off, I'd like to thank the AHA for allowing us to present these awards at this event. Foundation Beyond Belief does not have our own conference. And the last 2 years, we have presented these awards at the American Humanist Association Conference. And we appreciate their generosity in allowing us to do that. I actually had a write-up that I was going to do to introduce the awards. And on the way here, I decided to do something else. So please bear with me on that. The reason I decided to do something else is because this conference is at Rice University. And whenever I come to Rice University, I remember, you know, how places or things evoke our memory. I remember my friend Daniel. He graduated from Rice as a mechanical engineer. We met working at Chevron in 2004. We both started in the same year. 13 years ago, this September, Daniel died in a tragic car accident as a passenger with a drunk driver. I was the last person to hug Daniel before he died on a street very close to here. This impacted me in a profound way. I felt a great deal of responsibility. I felt a great deal of grief. I still do. Even though we weren't really close friends, I don't know what Daniel believed. It was pre my activism days, and I wasn't really having those types of conversations. But the reason that I bring Daniel up today is because that event changed the course of my life. As a humanist, I believe that this life is the only life that we have. As a humanist, I believe that life is short and can end at any time. We can make a choice. We can fill the life we have with distractions, pleasantries, which is nice, not gonna lie. Or we can do what we can, when we can, to make an impact on the world around us. We can work to create equality so that others can be free to make that choice as well. That's what the individuals and the groups that I'm about to give awards to today are doing. And that's why I'm honored and pleased to be able to present Foundation Beyond Belief's Heart of Humanism Awards. Our first award goes to the Humanist Community of Central Ohio. It is the Backbone Volunteers Award for our teams who played a consistent and reliable role with a local organization. HCCO volunteered every month with their local community shelter board, which provides housing and meals to families and individuals experiencing homelessness. Some volunteers served dinners, while others washed dishes, mopped floors, and cleaned tables. Helping to serve meals and clean up, and they have continued their partnership of several years. Every time they volunteer, they wear branded t-shirts to raise awareness of non-theists doing service. This award comes with a $100 grant to support their future service. I don't believe anyone from HCCO is here today, but this is their award. Thank you. Congratulations to HCCO. The Best Photo of the Year is our next award. Each month, we have a competition for the team who submitted the best photo from an event that month. At the end of the year, we review each month's winners and decide which one was the best for the year. Jefferson Humanists in Golden, Colorado won the award for Best Picture of the Month in November This image is from their jacket and coat donation drive, benefiting low-income residents of their community. And no one from that group is here. I do believe we have a representative from the next group. This award is our Gimme Food and Shelter Award. It's presented to Atheist Community of Colorado Springs for outstanding contributions to causes related to homelessness and food assistance. ACCS had 34 events in 2018 in these areas. Their craftivists meet regularly to knit and crochet hats and scarves to donate to area, middle, and high schools. School social workers distribute them to students who they know are in need. Also, twice a month, ACCS volunteers meet to crochet sleeping mats out of plastic bags, which they add to other donations to give a local charity that supports people experiencing homelessness. They save thousands of plastic bags from going to the landfill. This award comes with a $50 grant.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Thank you. Okay, our next award is the Rookie of the Year. Our Rookie of the Year award is given to a team that joined our Beyond Belief Network in the previous year and stood out from the crowd. New Orleans Secular Humanist Association joined us in October of 2018 and quickly worked their way to bronze level in only a couple of months, which is the first tier of our levels, with a no AIDS walk and events with the local food bank. We're very excited to see what they'll accomplish next year, and this is Aaron Rooney as a representative of NOSHA. Okay, there we go.
Okay, thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you. Oh, this award comes with a $50 grant as well. Okay, so the next award, which is the last of our paper awards, is Eat, Sleep, Volunteer, Repeat. This award is for the most events in a calendar year. Austin Humanists at Work held 46 events in 2018. That's nearly one every week. Do we have anyone from Austin Humanists at Work here? No? Okay. We weren't sure. Congratulations to Austin Humanists at Work. Okay. We also have individual awards. Are we doing this one first? This is a team award. Sorry. Okay, we have one more team award, which is our highest team award. This award is presented to the Beyond Belief Network team with the most volunteer hours in 2018. When we ran the numbers, we were amazed to find that Austin Humanists at Work had amassed over 4,000 hours in 2018 at service events. That's one group, 4,000 hours. So they will receive this lovely plaque award. Okay, now to the individual awards. Our first individual award is our Outstanding Leader Award. This is an award to recognize one of our BBN teams, Beyond Belief Network teams, for an outstanding leader. When we discussed these awards for 2018, this person of this group, their name came up over and over and over again. This award will go to T. Rogers of B. Orlando. B. Orlando is a community of compassionate atheists, humanists, freethinkers, and people of other non-religious identities, as well as allies of faith. They believe in making the world a better place and overcoming stereotypes about non-religious people through service and education. In 2018, B. Orlando was a gold level Beyond Belief Network team with events including mattress recycling at a furniture and clothing bank, an annual Pie Day event, which included STEM games and a pie buffet for at-risk youth, and an event in which they braved an alligator-infested lake to plant shoreline grass and stabilize a wake-impacted habitat area. Beat Orlando organizes a wide range of events while returning to community partners with reliable commitments. They are making effective, compassionate impacts in their communities. That is humanism at work. Please help me congratulate T. Rogers. He's going to speak for a few minutes.
They're giving me the microphone. So thank you very much. For 10 awesome years, the Foundation Beyond Belief has done essential work around humanist volunteerism and philanthropy. And one of FBB's amazing superpowers is that they normalize, legitimize, and empower local organizations like Be Orlando. We increase visibility and acceptance of non-religious people through service, education, and advocacy. This is important, and it is work worth doing. There are many atheists, humanists, freethinkers, and other non-religious identities who hesitate to volunteer, to donate, to pursue careers in social service, and even to seek needed assistance because of the potential for how they might be treated at faith-biased organizations. So I wanted to take this opportunity to ask for your help with two small things that I believe can change the world. The first is, as you're out there volunteering, focus on building relationships with those charities. Let them know who you are, and if you feel safe, let them know that you are a person or an organization of non-faith. If it's appropriate at that charity, please wear t-shirts, secular t-shirts, team t-shirts that let other people see who you are. And FBB team t-shirts are a great opportunity to do that. I was going to wear one to model it for you today, but it just wasn't out and loud enough for the Houston airport for me. Where you don't volunteer, you can still make a difference. You can reach out to charities, connect with them, ask for opportunities to talk to their leadership, and talk to them about the challenges potentially faced by people of non-faith and what that can mean to their constituents. All right, so you've all heard the term faith-based organizations, right? Heard this? I see this a lot. Okay. The other thing I want to ask you to do is stop using that term and start using faith-biased organization unapologetically. If a charity's faith is part of their mission or services, we need to call attention to that bias, because passively and actively, it marginalizes and others people who don't share that faith. In some cases, they just haven't thought about the impact that that might be having on people, on the people that they serve, and on the people that they're hoping will serve with them. They understand from empathy, right? It's not about trying to change their perspective or their faith. It's about trying to tap into that empathy. They wouldn't want to have to pray to someone else's God in order to help build houses for people in need or in order to feed their own hungry children. So they understand what that will mean. Secular people and our allies of faith need our advocacy and our action. Franklin D. Roosevelt once said, "Far and away, the greatest prize life offers is the chance to work hard at work worth doing." And I am honored and grateful for the opportunity to have played a small role in this work. And I'm grateful for all of those who have stood shoulder to shoulder with us, both together in person and out in your various different groups, working to make this world a better place. Thank you for the difference that you're making in your communities, and keep finding ways to expand your visibly secular kindness footprint. Thank you.
Thank you, T. Our highest award, the Heart of Humanism, is for outstanding contributions to compassionate humanism. And it goes today to Phil Session of Beyond Belief Network Team's Freethinkers Association of Central Texas, FACT, in San Antonio, and Austin Help Atheists Helping the Homeless, Austin AHH. Phil works tirelessly. If you know him, you know that's true. Phil works tirelessly to support and promote humanist values in his communities. He coordinates multiple monthly volunteer events in two cities. Phil is the volunteer coordinator for FACT. In San Antonio, he's organized FACT projects to build ramps for low-income residents, including veterans, living with disabilities, service events at food banks, and volunteer projects with organizations that provide holistic support to people experiencing homelessness. Phil is also coordinator for Austin Atheists Helping the Homeless, which spends every first Sunday of the month under an overpass in downtown Austin distributing food, toiletries, clothing, sanitary supplies, and other necessities like flashlights and pet food to people experiencing homelessness. In addition to all the service he is coordinating and doing, he is also one of the rotating co-hosts for the webcast, Atheist Experience. Congratulations, Phil. Please help me congratulate Phil Session. Congratulations. Thank you so much for everything you do.
Oh, wow. Well, thank you so much, Noel, and to Foundation Beyond Belief for this award. As I said when I first received the award, I was very humbled by it. It's when I initially got into my activism in the atheist community, I never expected to, you know, be so exposed, to be so in front of things. I was, you know, more than willing to be, you know, that behind the scenes person, just kind of moving things along. But I want to give a special shout out to everyone that has come out to all of these events. There's been so many events that it was hard for me to count, and I tried to do so even before I came here. And over just the last 3 years, I was able to count about 7,500 volunteer hours that have been put in by my wonderful friends and family in the Austin and San Antonio regions of Texas. And I'm so eternally grateful. So I want to take a little time. I may miss some people, but I really wanted to make some time to thank so many of those that come out, you know, month after month to do, to help, because it takes a village to do the impact that these organizations do. FACT down in San Antonio, Austin AHH up in Austin. It takes so much to get these projects together, and so much preparation time that's on that side. And so for the Austin side, Lynn, Sean, Brandy, Arthur and his little ones, Alexis and her little one, Dixie, Mark, Emily, Ernesto, who helps on the ramps, Dick, who helps to coordinate those ramp projects there in Austin, Sharon, Pamela, Roy, and Susanna, who is the representative for I Support the Girls, who supplies all of our feminine hygiene products in the Austin area for like almost the last 3 years. Has been awesome. But and down in San Antonio, Deb, Katie, Jackie and Bryce, Brian, Anthony and Hector, who just spoke here at the American Humanist Association conference today, as a matter of fact, come out to the ramps down in San Antonio. But Gary, Letty, Glenn, Chelsea, and Sean, I want to say thank you to you all. When I realized that I was an atheist and realized I didn't even know that I was a humanist, because I didn't really know that term at that time, but I knew that me being an atheist and realizing that this is the only life that we have evidence that we're going to live, that this is the only life that we know we're going to have an impact on others, to share, to laugh, to cry, to go out and have an effect on our communities. And it fueled my passion for wanting to get out there and have an impact locally. And the way that I see atheism, all the misconceptions that people have about people that are non-believers, there's a lot of avenues to go about it. Anthony talked earlier about street epistemology as a way to try to break that barrier. And, you know, arguments and debates, there's so many different ways. But for me, community service and going out into our local communities and showing that non-believers, humanists, are real people. They're people that care about those in our neighborhoods. They're people that care and want to make a difference in the small amount of time that we have on this planet to make an impact on others, and the small amount of time that the people that we're affecting have in this world. That is the effect that I wanted to take. And as I said before, I'm so humbled that FBB chose me for this honor. It was amazing when I was told about it in the first place, and it was just like, whoa, like, what do I do with this? But I really want to stress for those in your local community, not everyone can be out, but for those that can, as T spoke about earlier, it's important to be out because it starts to break through this wall of the preconceived notions that people have about what non-believers believe, what they, how they interact, that they're not just some heathens in a dark corner, you know, just muttering to them, just very angry at the world, but actually, you know, are caring, compassionate people just like everyone else. And when disaster strikes and everything else, and everyone talks about all these faith groups that go into faith bias groups, as you referred to, that there are also secular organizations that are out there that are trying to make a difference because, you know, not because of a faith or not because we're appealing to a higher power, but because we understand that the problems that we see around us are only going to be solved if we come together as a community to do something about them, that it's in our hands to make that difference in the time that we have to do so. It's important to do so. And so, for the ramps we build, for the trees that we plant, the food that we pack, the streets that we clean, the people that we go out to feed, the lives that we impact month after month, it's worth it to do so. So if you can, in your local communities, get out there and try to make that impact as a non-believer if you can, because you make a difference to not only the people that you have a direct impact on, but also the community of people that cannot be out because they're afraid of their family or someone, you know, those stigmas that we're still trying to break through. It's so important on so many different levels, but at the bottom line, there are problems in the world that are not going to get solved unless we get out there and do something about them. And so I encourage you all to do so. And I want to thank FBB so much for this award. Thank you.